Hello students, I'm your Jet sir, welcoming you all in the new video of the science and technology for standard 10. In this new video, we will going to start our new chapter, that is chapter number 2, acids, bases and salts. This is our part 1 of this new chapter. Let's start without any interruption. So first point is acid. So how we will can say that there is presence of acid in any substance? So we can get to know by their taste. So in chemistry ke andar kya hota hai, aap taste nahi kar sakte usko, tongue se taste nahi kar sakte. So when you are in laboratory, so you have to taste, aapko taste karna hota, T-E-S-T test karna hota, T-A-S-T-E test nahi karna hota, theek hai. So for that in laboratory we have different types of indicator that shows that us that there is a presence of acid and there is a presence of base. So here how we will test, we will can test through a litmus paper. So acid are sour in taste, that means wo thoda khatta hota hai. Then after we had get to know that these turn blue litmus to red. So when we want to identify that there is a presence of acid or no, so we can get to know that this litmus paper is converted into red in color. Third point is, when we are using this acid in a aqueous solution, the acid release H plus ion. Acid kya release kar raha hai? H plus ion release kar raha hai. This is one mark question which will be asked in exam. Keep in your mind. So fourth point is, acid corrode the metals. Acid क्या करता है? Metal को corrode कर देता है, मतलब उसको सड़ा देता है. Coming on to the example of acid, are strong acid and weak acid. So which are the strong acid? Let's see. Hydrochloric acid and sulfuric acid are the example for the strong acid. Where is the weak acid? Example are acetic acid, oxalic acid and citric acid. So these are the example for the acid. As we know that hydrochloric acid is produced in our body, yes, which I already explained in you chapter number 6, life process. Stomach mein hamare hydrochloric acid produce hota hai. And citric acid, to main aapko bolu to yahan pe example maine diya hua hai lemon ka, to usme citric acid present hota hai. So it is weak acid. ठीक है, तो लेमन का बहुत सारे फायदे होते हैं. एसिड की वजह से हमें किसी भी चीज को कोरोड, मतलब सड़ा देता है. तो हमारे जो लेमन होता है वो क्या करता है, हमारी जो भी फैट होती है बॉडी में उसको भी कम करता है. तो बोलते हैं ना, यू हैव टू ड्रिंक द वाटर विद द पोर ऑफ सम ऑफ लेमन, सो इट विल हेल्प अस टू रिड्यूस अवर वेट ऑल्सो. Now there are two types of acid, that is a concentrated acid and dilute acid. So concentrated acid, that means when there is a presence of more acid in water, okay, so you can call as a concentrated acid. And if there is a less acid compared to water, water zyada rehta hai aur acid kam rahega, you can call that this is called as a dilute acid. Clear students? Now coming on to the next point, that is bases. Now what is bases? So these are bitter in taste. Bitter means kadwa thoda rehta hai, theek hai. Second point, they turn red litmus to blue. So when we want to identify that if there is a base present in any substance, so the litmus converted into blue, that means there is a presence of base. Now when they give you ions, which ions they give? They give a OH minus ion in aqueous solution. So this is also one more question, that in aqueous solution bases give a OH ion, OH minus ion in aqueous solution release. Now soapy in touch, so these bases are soapy in touch. For example, I had given you an example of soap. Yahan pe you all aware of, when you touch the soap in your hand, which type of feeling you get? This is called as a soapy touch. Okay, so soap have presence of a base in it. Clear? So see here, the soap is converted into blue in color. I explain you and I give you the example which is related to you. You and which is surrounding to you, मैं उसी तरीके का आपको example देता हूँ जो आपको अच्छे समझ में आ जाए. Now strong base, which are the strong base? The strong base are NaOH, KOH and CaOH by 2 are the strong base. What is weak base? So weak base are NH4OH are called as a weak base. Okay, students, this is also important. Keep in your mind. Okay, now alkali. Alkali kya hai? These are bases which are soluble in water. Alkali means what? The substance. This is also called a basis. Alkali is also a basis, and the basis which are soluble in water. जो कोई भी basis होते हैं वो soluble हो जाते हैं water के अंदर, उसे alkali बोलते हैं. ठीक है, तो they are NaOH. Clear students? Now moving on to the next point, that is indicator. So indicator, these are the substance which change the color, smell in different types of substance. Now indicator plays a very important role in the chemistry. Okay, as I already told you, if you want to test, the indicator plays a very important role. ओके, फोरेंसिक साइंस, अभी जो फोरेंसिक साइंस होती है उसमें भी आपने देखा होगा, किसी भी तरीके का हमें कुछ भी जानना होता है तो हम क्या करते हैं, किसी भी केमिकल लेते हैं, उसको उस पर दो तीन ड्रॉप डालते हैं, एंड वी कैन गेट टू नो दैट देयर इज अ समथिंग, वी गेट द प्रूफ. यू ऑलरेडी अवेयर ऑफ CID. ओके, सो इन CID द फोरेंसिक लैब, have you seen the forensic lab? वो इसी तरीके की लेबोरेटरी, केमिकल लेबोरेटरी होती है, उसमें उसी तरीके के सब इक्विपमेंट होते हैं, उसमें इसी तरीके से सब टेस्टिंग होती है. तो CID का एग्जाम्पल आप ले सकते हैं, उसमें फोरेंसिक लैब होती है. ठीक है, सो इंडिकेटर विच गिव यू द डिफरेंट सब्सटेंस कलर एंड चेंज द स्मेल ऑफ दैट सब्सटेंस. सो देर आर थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ इंडिकेटर. Okay, so first one is the natural indicator. Which are natural indicator? Natural indicator are litmus and turmeric. So we get from nature is called a natural indicator. So when litmus is used to identify the acid, so it changes in red color. And when litmus is used to identify base, so it changes into a blue in color. Second is a turmeric. So turmeric you can call as a haldi. Okay, so when haldi, that means the turmeric is used to identify a acid, so it converted into a original state only. Turmeric will not change its color. Okay, when we are using to identify the acid, so it will not change its color. Turmeric is in yellow in color and it will stain yellow in color. And if it change to red in color, so you can call that there is a presence of base in that substance. Okay, if you don't have litmus paper, you can use a haldi or you can say turmeric for your indicator. So this is a natural indicator. Now after we had get to know that natural indicator, so we are the human being, we are not hum piche nahi rahenge, to humne khud se indicator bana liye, so we can call as a synthetic indicator. So these indicators are chemical substance, so which is prepared in the chemical laboratory. So example for that is methylene orange and phenolphthalein. So methylene orange ko when we are using to identify the acid and base, so methylene orange change in red in color, so we can call that there is a presence of acid. And if it is raised, if it is stay in its original state, this yellow in color, that you can call as there is a presence of base. When we are using a phenolphthalein, okay, so phenolphthalein change in white in color, वो colorless रहता है, उसका color रहता ही नहीं, ऐसा बोल सकता हूँ, कोई भी color होगा उसका वो color नहीं होगा, वो पूरा white इस color हो जाएगा, देख लिया आप यहाँ पे. So it is, it give the presence of acid. And when phenolphthalein unused, and if it is showing us a very dark color of pink, okay, you can call as there is a presence of base. Now the third indicator is olfactory indicator. So what is olfactory indicator? The substance have different odor in acid and base. So olfactory indicator, that means when you are using a indicator and where their odor change, odor means smell change, okay, when we are using acid and base substance, these are called a olfactory indicator. So vanilla essence and clove oil are the example for olfactory indicator. Clove oil means जो तेल होता है, ठीक है, एंड दैट ऑयल व्हेन वी यूजिंग, तेल कौन सा, लौंग का तेल, ठीक है, क्लोव ऑयल, दैट मीन्स लौंग का जो तेल होता है, अगर व्हेन वी आर यूजिंग दिस ऑयल एज ए इंडिकेटर, तो उसका अगर खुशबू जो होती है, स्मेल अगर बढ़ जाएगी, यू कैन कॉल दैट देयर इज अ प्रेजेंस ऑफ एसिड. एंड इफ द स्मेल इज degrees or you can say decrease कम हो जाती है, so you can call as a base, presence of base. And you are already aware of vanilla essence. We are using in vanilla essence many cooking place. Okay, हम खाना पकाते हैं वहाँ पे कहीं ना कहीं वेनीला डालते हैं. अगर आइसक्रीम घर में बनाते हैं, अगर हम कहीं पे चॉकलेट घर में बना रहे हैं तो वेनीला एसेंस डालते हैं. केक बनाते फिर भी वेनीला एसेंस डालते हैं. सो व्हेन वी आर यूजिंग वेनीला एसेंस एंड इट्स जो स्मेल होती है वो बढ़ जाती है, तो यू कैन कॉल दैट देयर इज अ प्रेजेंस ऑफ एसिड. एंड इट एंड इफ इट इज डजंट स्मेल यू, यू कैन कॉल दैट देयर इज अ प्रेजेंस ऑफ बेस. मतलब वहाँ पे बेस है अगर स्मेल आती ही नहीं है. So now we had understand the what is base, what is acid. We had get through this example. Okay, then after we had get to know that how to identify the acid and base, we had come to an indicator. So we had also know what is indicator. We had get to know that there are three types of indicator. There are natural indicator, synthetic indicator, and olfactory indicator. Now let's come on to chemical reaction. Let's start. So chemical properties of acid and base. We will gonna study now the chemical properties of acid and base. So when acid react with metal, what give us? And when acid react with base, what give us? So when acid react with metal, it give us salt plus hydrogen gas. So example of acid, we are taking 2HCl, and example of metal, that is Zn, zinc. So when they both react, they give us salt plus hydrogen, that is ZnCl2 are a salt, one type of salt, okay, and H2, that is a hydrogen. So which type of reaction are occurring here? You can call that acid is reacting with metal is a chemical reaction, but here the reaction, chemical reaction are called a displacement reaction. See, yahan pe Zn kiski jagah le raha hai, hydrogen ki jagah le raha hai in dono ke beech mein. So yahan pe kya mile, ZnCl2 mil raha hai, so you can call that there is a displacement reaction. Okay students, now there is a byproduct is H2 gas. Now coming on to the base, when the base is react with the metal, it give a salt plus hydrogen. Hume kya mila hai? Salt plus hydrogen mila hai. In both the case we get the salt plus hydrogen, but with metal we are using a different reactant. Here we are using base. So which are the base we are using here? 2NaOH, okay, so plus Zn, that is a metal. So when they both are react, it give us sodium zincate, okay, that is Na2ZnO2. It is also one type of salt and byproduct is H2 over here. So which type of reaction occurring here? Oxidation reaction. Okay, here the hydrogen is removed. As we know that removal of hydrogen and addition of oxygen are called as a oxidation reaction. So here the oxidation reaction occur. Clear? Now moving forward. Now how we can say that there is a hydrogen is there in the chemical reaction? So we want to do activity. So testing of hydrogen gas. So hydrogen gas release can be tested by bringing burning candle near gas bubble. It brushed with pop sound. अब यहाँ पे क्या हो रहा है? जो hydrogen gas, अगर हमें जानना, if want to know that there is a hydrogen gas present in that chemical reaction, you have to do activity. So taking this chemical reaction, okay, in this particular setup, so we can get to know that there is HCl and there is a zinc granule and in test tube. On this particular process, so with the help of pipe, this hydrogen gas will be come out with the help of it form bubbles. So this is a soapy, you can say soapy solution. ठीक है, जब हाइड्रोजन गैस में जाएगा तो बबल्स बनेंगे उसके. एंड व्हेन वी ब्रिंग दैट हाइड्रोजन गैस नियर टू दैट बबल एंड इफ द साउंड पॉप लाइक ए पट करके आवाज आएगा ना, यू कैन कॉल दैट देयर इज अ प्रेजेंस ऑफ हाइड्रोजन. सो वी कैन गेट टू नो दैट, हाउ टू गेट टू नो दैट फ्रॉम दिस एक्टिविटी. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ मूविंग फॉरवर्ड. सो रिएक्शन ऑफ मेटल कार्बोनेट, metal hydrogen carbonate with acid and base. Now we will going to study acid react with metal carbonate and metal hydrogen carbonate. So which byproduct it give to us? So when the acid react with the metal carbonate and metal hydrogen carbonate, give us salt. CO2 plus hydrogen. In last reaction हमने जब देखा था metal के साथ react हो रहा है जब acid, तो हमें क्या salt plus हमें क्या मिला था, हाइड्रोजन गैस मिला था, H2 मिला था. जब वो एसिड रिएक्ट कर रहा है मेटल कार्बोनेट और मेटल हाइड्रोजन कार्बोनेट के साथ, तो व्हाट वी आर गेटिंग, वी आर गेटिंग वाटर प्लस CO2. ओके, सो द एग्जांपल फॉर द एसिड आर व्हेन द एसिड इज रिएक्टिंग विद मेटल कार्बोनेट, मेटल कार्बोनेट दैट इज Na2CO3. ओके, मेटल कार्बोनेट, इफ यू वांट टू आइडेंटिफाई द मेटल कार्बोनेट, व्हिच आर द मेटल कार्बोनेट, सो देयर इज द प्रेजेंस ऑफ कार्बन. ओके, देयर इज presence of carbon, you can call that these are the metal carbonate. So when they both are react with each other, they give us NaCl plus CO2 plus H2O. So NaCl are the salt, okay, CO2 and H2O are our byproduct. So when the acid are react with the metal hydrogen carbonate, देखिए अब metal hydrogen carbonate और metal carbonate में क्या फर्क है, देखिए यहाँ पर hydrogen आ गया, you can call this as a metal hydrogen carbonate. When they both are react with each other, they give us NaCl plus CO2 plus H2O. So this is our byproduct. So this is also a salt, this is a CO2 and this is a H2O. Okay. Students, now when the base is react with the metal carbonate and metal hydrogen carbonate, what it give us? So base do not react with the metal carbonate and metal hydrogen carbonate. So वो एक reaction आपकी कम हो गई, आपके लिए फायदा हुआ कि base कभी भी react नहीं होता. Base is not react with or it not carry out the chemical reaction with the metal carbonate and metal hydrogen carbonate. So it is one more important question. That is it base is reacting with metal carbonate or metal hydrogen carbonate, yes or no, then you can ask in fill in the blanks also or in the MCQ also, or else one mark sentence question also, aapko one mark question ke answer bhi aate hain, usme bhi puch sakte hain. Let's move forward. Before moving forward, in last slide we had understand that how to identify the hydrogen gas H2, so we had go through these activities. Now here another gas is produced, that is CO2. So how we can say that there is a chemical there is a gas produced, you can call it CO2. So let's do one activity. So testing of CO2. So when we are testing a CO2, the CO2, that means carbon dioxide. So CO2 can be tested by passing it through a lime water. When we are passing that CO2 through a lime water, it gives us CaCO3 plus H2O. What it gives us? CaCO3 plus H2O. Initially, the lime water have no color. It is a colorless. Okay. When we are passing through a CO2 gas through this lime water, it gives us milky white. Okay. थोड़ा milky white देगा color. थोड़ा दूध जैसा color मिलेगा हमें. Milky white color plus H2O. And if we when pass more CO2 and we are passing excess CO2, so through this CaCO3 plus H2O, so it give us CaHOHCO3. Okay, it give us this product. So this is a colorless, so we can get to know that there is a presence of कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड इन दी केमिकल रिएक्शन. बहुत ही आसान है, लाइम वाटर लीजिए, CO2 को पास कीजिए, मिल्की वाटर मिलेगा और CO2 को पास होता रहेगा, और फिर से अगर कलरलेस हो गया, यू कैन कॉल दैट देयर इज अ प्रेजेंस ऑफ CO2 गैस इन दिस केमिकल रिएक्शन. वेरी इजी. सो इट इज योर इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन फॉर 2 मार्क्स ऑल्सो, टेस्टिंग ऑफ CO2. यस स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ मूविंग ऑन टू नेक्स्ट पॉइंट, दैट इज reaction of acid and base with each other. Up to here we had understand acid react with metal, it gives some product. Acid react with metal, it gives some product. Base react with metal, it gives some product. Acid react with metal carbonate, or you can say metal hydrogen carbonate, it gives us product, whereas base is not reacting with that. Now when acid and base both are reacting with each other, what they give us? So when acid and base reacting with each other, acid plus base, so it give us salt. तो हमें अभी तक ये पता चला कि जब कभी भी एसिड को किसी मेटल के साथ रिएक्ट कर रहे हैं, या मेटल कार्बोनेट के साथ रिएक्ट कर रहे हैं, या मेटल हाइड्रोजन कार्बोनेट के साथ रिएक्ट कर रहे हैं, तो हमें क्या मिल रहा है? सोल्ट ही बाई प्रोडक्ट में मिलता है. ठीक है, सोल्ट ही हमें मिलता है. यू कैन कीप इन योर माइंड. एंड वेन वी आर reacting acid plus base also, we are also getting a salt. So it is a very important question. So taking the example for it, So HCl is our acid, NaOH is our base. As I already told you that when we are taking the both reaction, so as we know the acid releasing the H plus ion and base release OH minus ion. Okay, so it gives the byproduct as NaCl plus H2O. I already told you NaCl is salt and H2O as it is. So these are the chemical reaction. It is very simple and very easy. बहुत ही आसान है. केमिस्ट्री इतना कोई डिफिकल्ट नहीं होता. सो न्यूट्रलाइजेशन रिएक्शन. सो व्हेन एन एसिड एंड बेस रिएक्ट टू फॉर्म ए वाटर एंड सॉल्ट कॉल्ड न्यूट्रलाइजेशन रिएक्शन. यस, व्हाट इज न्यूट्रलाइजेशन रिएक्शन? न्यूट्रलाइजेशन रिएक्शन मींस व्हेन एसिड एंड बेस रिएक्ट विथ ईच अदर. जब एसिड और बेस एक दूसरे के साथ रिएक्ट करेंगे तो हमें सॉल्ट मिलेगा प्लस वाटर मिलेगा. तो दिस टाइप ऑफ रिएक्शन यू कैन कॉल्ड एज ए न्यूट्रलाइजेशन रिएक्शन. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, सो एज आई ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू दैट इट इन्वॉल्व्स एच प्लस आयन एंड ओ एच माइनस आयन टू जनरेट वाटर. क्लियर हाउ द वाटर वी गेटिंग फ्रॉम दिस? बिकॉज ऑफ दिस एच प्लस आयन एंड ओ एच माइनस आयन. क्लियर, let's move forward. So reaction of metal oxide with acid. Now acid is reacting with metal oxide. So similarly acid give us, as I told you, if it is reacting with metal oxide it give us salt plus water. So which are the acid we are taking here? We are taking here HCl as a acid, metal oxide are CaO. How we can get to know that this is a metal oxide? Because the presence of oxygen. So metal oxide are, you can call as a one type of basic. Okay, they are basic in nature. Example of basic in nature, metal oxide CaO and MgO, magnesium oxide. आपने देख लिया है first chapter में पहली activity है, ठीक है? Rubbing of magnesium when react with air, वो आपने पूरा फर्स्ट एक्टिविटी देख लिया फर्स्ट चैप्टर में. सो व्हेन दिस मेटल ऑक्साइड रिएक्ट विद एसिड इट गिव अस सॉल्ट प्लस H2O. व्हाट इज सॉल्ट हियर? CaCl2 इज अ सॉल्ट एंड वाटर एज इट इज. ओके स्टूडेंट, दिस हैव यू अंडरस्टैंड? ना, कमिंग ऑन टू द रिएक्शन ऑफ नॉन मेटल ऑक्साइड विथ बेस. अब नॉन मेटल ऑक्साइड किसके साथ रिएक्ट करेगा? बेस के साथ रिएक्ट करेगा. नॉन मेटल ऑक्साइड आर एसिडिक नेचर. मेटल ऑक्साइड कैसा होता है? बेसिक नेचर होता है. जबकि नॉन मेटल ऑक्साइड कैसा होता है? एसिडिक इन नेचर होता है. एंड व्हेन दे रिएक्ट विथ बेस दे गिव अस सॉल्ट प्लस H2O. लेट टेक एग्जांपल ओवर हियर. बेस इज आवर CaOH बाय 2 प्लस CO2. इट गिव अस CaCO3 दैट इज आवर सॉल्ट एंड H2O इट्स आवर वाटर. क्लियर स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ वी हैड कंप्लीटेड अप टू हियर. हमने यहाँ तक सब कुछ समझ लिया है. हमें पता चल गया कि जब एसिड किसी मेटल के साथ रिएक्ट करता है, बेस के साथ रिएक्ट कर रहा है, या किसी मेटल कार्बोनेट के साथ रिएक्ट कर रहा है, या मेटल हाइड्रोजन कार्बोनेट के साथ रिएक्ट करता है, तो हमें क्या मिलता है? हमें मिलता है सॉल्ट. तो हमें इस सब चीज़ें को अच्छे से ध्यान रखनी है. जहाँ जहाँ मैंने बोला है वो सबको अच्छे से प्रिपेयर करना है. और मैंने आपके लिए अच्छे से ये बना के रखी है स्लाइड, अच्छे से नोट्स बना के लिखिए. तो आप बुक में भी लिख लीजिए. सो दैट विल हेल्प यू इन योर प्रिपरेशन ऑफ एग्जाम एट द टाइम ऑफ रिवीजन. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, सो नेक्स्ट पार्ट वी विल कम टू द न्यू पॉइंट्स. सो टिल देन आई एम योर ज़ेड सर एंडिंग दिस वीडियो ओवर हियर. बाय बाय.